UDF has not even spared the rays of the sun. About LDF, it can be said, Judas betrayed Lord Christ for a few pieces of silver. LDF had betrayed Kerala for a few pieces of gold. The politics of our nation had been affected by five diseases. They are corruption, casteism, communalism, cronyism, and when I say cronyism, which includes nepotism and dynasty politics, and fifth, criminalization. And the root cause of this disease is the super disease of vote bank politics. UDF and LDF are masters at such vote bank politics. The young and first time voter of Kerala is seeing how both alliances are bowing to regressive elements of society. It is clear the UDF and LDF have two aims: further vote bank politics, fill pockets. This comfortable agreement is all set to be rejected. Your candidate, Metro Man Sridharanji, everyone wants well-educated people to enter politics. But thanks to Metro Man Sridharanji, I am seeing something for the first time. A man who achieved so much in life, a man who has done excellent work to make India modern and improve connectivity, a man who is admired by all sections of society, he's a proud son of Kerala. He had devoted himself for Kerala's progress. If he wanted only power, he could have got it even 20 years ago. Yet, as a true son of Kerala, he thought beyond power. He knew he would be attacked, but he stayed firm on his commitment to Kerala. He is an inspiration for all, especially for professionals. The high number of roadblocks by UDF and LDF has made the speed of development slower. That is why the time has come for fast development in Kerala, which BJP promises. By fast, what I mean is F for fisheries and fertilizers, A for agriculture and Ayurveda, S for skill development and social justice, T for tourism and technology. Kerala and tourism have a close link. Sadly, UDF and LDF have not done much to improve tourism infrastructure here. There is one important topic on which I want to speak on from this land of Palakkad. It is about the LDF and UDF's direct attack on Kerala's culture. These parties are ashamed of the culture of our land. Their leaders abuse our tradition and ethos. LDF government should be ashamed of showering lathis on innocent devotees. UDF should be ashamed of remaining silent when this was happening. I am proud to belong to a party that has and is and will always defend the culture of our land. I want to tell the LDF and UDF, your lathis will not scare us. If you abuse our culture, we will not be silent spectators.